So maybe this might be the first time you've actually met a real live deaf person, so you may not have met deaf patients before.
Number one, the first thing that you need to keep in mind is always try to use gestural language. Use gestures to communicate. Otherwise, it's all going over people's heads and they don't know what you're talking about. Two, the second thing you should try is paper and pen. If your gestures don't work, try the paper and pen. Try to write to them. Keep for the last option, absolutely last, is oral, where you depend on them to recognize what you're saying.
And make sure you keep it short and sweet. Kiss, keep it short and sweet. Because unfortunately, out there in the wider deaf community, a lot of deaf people haven't had access to good education and may not have had good communication with their families. And that's a high percentage of the deaf community, so they have low literacy skills and quite delayed and had that language deprivation. So that's a really important thing that you may not be aware of. So they might have deaf friends that they communicate with and hang out with, but in their home environment, with a hearing family, a lot of kids have missed out on education because interpreters were provided at school and they didn't have that high level of access to education. But it's just an unfortunate nature of things.